Hello, it's Classy49 here, and today I'm going to quickly show you some settings that should be turned on or off in your system and your game settings that will help you get the best performance possible in Fortnite in this new chapter. So go to your settings, let's run through the game settings quickly and then move to Windows settings. So make sure it's on performance mode, go to rendering mode, choose performance mode to get the best performance possible. Show FPS, this is personal preference, VSync off, VSync should be turned off, never turn it on. For the meshes, textures, and view distance, this is personal preference. And if you have a bad PC, you should lower them down. I have an RTX graphics card, so I don't mind putting them on high ultra like this and apply. I don't really have a problem with this. But if you have a GTX-based graphics card and if it's like pretty low VRAM, you just should lower this and keep lowering them until you find the best performance for you. And then, yeah, stick with medium or whatever you want. So you should play with this because it depends on your computer. Let's move all the way up to window mode. You want to put it on full screen. Don't put it on windowed or borderless, which is windowed full screen. Keep it on full screen. Resolution, your max resolution here. My max is 1920 by 1080. My monitor is 1080p. So yeah, for the frame rate limit, keep it on unlimited. Don't cap it. Keep it on unlimited for the best input lag possible. When you finish all of this, quit the game. And let's move to the real settings. First of all, type background apps in your Windows search bar and disable background apps. These apps are going to be running while you're playing and you don't want that. They're so annoying. Go back again and type game mode settings. In game mode settings, you want to have game mode turned on and go to graphics settings and turn on hardware acceleration, which is going to help your CPU get more FPS in the game. But it will need more power, which we're going to provide the power to the CPU later. So now let's click Browse. And you want to go to Fortnite Windows Shipping Client. But if you don't know where your game is located, for me it's located in Disk C. Choose where it's located in your which hard drive or SSD you have. And then go to Program Files, Epic Games, Fortnite Game, Binaries, Windows 64, and Fortnite client Win64 shipping. So this is the one you want to click and add here, and then go to options, choose high performance, click save. If you're not sure, you can add all of these launchers, but for me, I'm pretty sure it's the shipping one. After you finish this, close it and go back to your search bar. This time, click type power. Power, just type power and click on the battery and choose power options. So most people are going to be on balanced. You don't want to be on balanced. You want to be on high performance or AMD high performance. Okay. But I have ultimate performance. So why not? For the people who don't have ultimate performance, and most of the people are watching don't have ultimate performance, they can get it easily by going to Google and typing ultimate performance power command. Ultimate performance power command, and then go to any of these websites and they're going to provide you with a command line which I'm going to put in the description below. You don't have to search it up, which is this one. Copy it and run back to the search bar, type cmd, run it as administrator, and paste that line there. Control v, click control v on your keyboard and click enter. That's it. You go back, you'll find it here. If you don't find it, restart your PC and you will find ultimate performance. After you do all of this, right-click on your desktop, choose NVIDIA Control Panel for the NVIDIA users. For AMD users, I'm sorry, the video ends here, and you can leave and leave a like as well if you want. But if you're on NVIDIA, stay with me. Go to Adjust Image Settings, choose Advanced 3D Settings, click Apply, go back to Manage 3D Settings, and focus with me in these quick settings. Scroll all the way down, start with VSync, want it off. Okay, I'm going to run through the most important ones. I'm not going to run through the non-necessary ones. Okay, Vertical Sync off, Texture Filtering Quality High Performance, Shader Cache Size Driver Default, and preferred refresh rate highest available, power management mode maximum performance, OpenGL choose your GPU, monitor technology if you have G-Sync. If you don't have G-Sync, then that's a bit sad, but if you have G-Sync, turn it on. Low latency mode? Okay, when it comes to low latency mode, focus with me, guys. So if you have a bad CPU, okay, and a really good GPU, so there's a bottleneck in your system, then you put in an ultra. But if you have a decent CPU that can run the GPU really fine and you get nice GPU usage in the game, then put it on. But you don't want to have it on off. So either leave it on, or as I said, if you don't understand, just leave it on and move on. So if you have all of this set, you can click apply. And imagine, you're good to go, guys. Now you have to reboot your PC. But I forgot to tell you, you need to update your Windows to the latest update available and your graphics driver, which is the NVIDIA's. I don't have the GeForce Experience, but I'm pretty sure I have the latest driver in NVIDIA's graphics card. So yeah, after all this, you can restart your PC and you'll be good to go. Thanks for watching. Leave a like and see you in the next video.